It is our duty to preserve the freedom we got. It is our responsibility to hand over a better India to our coming generations. Let us work together and make it a happier country. I repeat my thought. It is our duty to preserve the freedom we got. It is our responsibility to hand over a better India to our coming generations. Let us work together and make it a happier country.
As it stands as a reminder of the sacrifices that so many freedom fighters made to get independence from the British rule. From the timeline of Indian freedom, struggles and movements, here are a few of them which made a difference. So here we are going to present our play. The Revolt of 1857, also known as Sepoy Mutiny, which started in Meerut, would turn Sepoy rebel Mangal Pandey.
We have served British Army with loyalty, but these people do not deserve our services. The cartridges given to us have been lubricated with the fat of cow and pig.
We will not fight for the British Army anymore.
Now this is the time to fight for freedom.
The rebellion started in Meerut and then spread to other parts of the country like Agra, Delhi, Kanpur and Lucknow.
During 1857 to 1858, the Army of East India Company attacked Jhansi. Maharani Lakshmibai of Jhansi defended her city and later she fought against British rule along with Tantya Tope of Gwalior. In 1858, British government announced that India will be ruled over by Queen Victoria of Britain.
In 1885, in response to the rise of British power over India, the Indian National Movement started and led to the formation of Indian National Congress.
Kheda district, Gujarat.
Gandhiji, we farmers are suffering from scarcity of food, will not be able to pay our taxes this year. We need a tax relaxation from the government.
I can see that you people will not be able to pay the revenue, but the government is threatening you that your land will be confiscated. We'll follow the rule of Satyagraha. We will not pay revenue, but our resistance will be non-violent.
After a few months, British government negotiated with farmers and provided them relaxation in taxes. Here the power of Satyagraha was important.
In 1927, British government appointed Simon Commission in India to decide India's political future, which was protested by Congress and Muslim League.
Simon Commission will not be having any members from India. So we are calling upon all the people and parties to protest against it and boycott this commission.
This march was being conducted peacefully, but British government ordered to police the lathi charge. The protesters during which Lala Lajpat Rai was hit.
I declare that the blow struck at me and others today will be nails in the coffin of British rule in India.
Lala Lajpat Rai died of his assault in 1928, which stirred a motion in national disobedience against the British rule.
In December 1929, Gandhiji led a mass civil disobedience movement, which was to cause total national disobedience towards the orders of British rule. In 1930, the famous Dandi March was organized by Gandhiji from his ashram at Sabarmati to coastal area of Gujarat called Dandi.
This march will be against the tax imposed by the government on salt. Salt is very important for all, rich and poor, and we are against the monopoly of the government over its production. This march is also an ultimatum to government over such policies.
This mass disobedience spread in addition to the salt tax, other unpopular tax laws such as forest law, Tokida tax, land tax, etc. were defied by the people.
The sacrifices of all the freedom fighters such as Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Vallabhbhai Patel and millions of unsung heroes should be given special honor and they will be remembered forever for their remarkable contribution.
After such long struggle, in June 1947, Lord Mountbatten announced at a press conference the date of independence, 15th August 1947. But this announcement also included that British India will be divided into two new dominions, India and Pakistan. On 15th August 1947, India got independence.
Indian Freedom Movement, also called Indian Independence Movement, is a series of activities that took place with the ultimate goal of achieving independence to bring an end to the British rule. So let's have a quick view on the great incidences of this freedom struggle, which spanned from 1857 to 1947.
Revolt of 1857, India's first war of independence, also known as Sepoy Mutiny, was the first time Indians united against the British Raj. This rebellion led to the dissolution of East India Company's rule in India.
Following the end of Indian Rebellion in 1858, the Dutch East India Company was disbanded and Queen Victoria of Britain decided to strengthen the control of British rule over India by proclaiming that India would be governed under the name of the British monarch.
In 1885, in the response to the rise of British power over India, Indian reformists led to the formation of Indian National Congress. The founders included Badruddin Tyabji, W.C. Banerjee, Surendranath Banerjee and Firoz Shah Mehta.
In 1905, partition of Bengal announced by Lord Curzon led a massive upsurge among the people, which gave a call for Swadeshi goods, leading to the boycott of British manufactured goods.
In 1906, Congress gave a call for Swaraj. At the same time, Muslim League was also founded at Dhaka by Aga Khan.
In 1908, Khairam Bose, the great freedom fighter, was executed for his attempt to assassinate a British general.
In 1915, Mahatma Gandhi returned to India from South Africa and emerged as a leader of the masses. His earliest interventions were local movement in Champaran, Kheda and Ahmedabad.
In 1919, another example of the British cruelty was the Roller Act, which allowed the British to imprison the people without due trial. To oppose the bill, public meeting was held on 13th April at Jallianwala Bagh, Amritsar. On this day, the Jallianwala massacre happened, which caused a rage in India against British rule.
In 1920, in retaliation to the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy, non-cooperation movement was started by Mahatma Gandhi with the aim of obtaining self-governance and avoiding the idea of non-violence or ahimsa.
In 1922, Mahatma Gandhi abruptly called off the non-cooperation movement when a crowd of farmers set fire to a police station in Chauri Chaura.
In 1929, Mahatma Gandhi led a mass civil disobedience movement, which was to cause total national disobedience towards the orders of the British rule.
In 1930, the most iconic act of civil disobedience was the Dandi March, when Gandhiji, along with a huge crowd, walked from Sabarmati to Dandi to protest against the repressive salt tax.
In 1930, he had planned to work salt flats on the beach encrusted with crystallized sea salt at every high tide. But the police had forestalled him by crushing salt deposits into the mud. Nevertheless, Gandhiji reached down and picked up a small lump of natural salt out of the mud, and British law had been defied.
In 1937, the provincial elections were held. Congress formed government in 7 out of 11 provinces. Even after two years of Congress rule in the provinces, the British refused to concede the demand of Indian independence.
In 1942, Mahatma Gandhi decided to initiate a new phase of movement called Quit India Movement against the British. To people, he said, "Do or die in your effort to fight the British," but it had to be undertaken non-violently.
The first response of the British was real repression, but the rebellion ultimately brought them to their knees, so they opened negotiation with the Congress and League.
In 1947, British Prime Minister Attlee announced the cabinet mission, and Jawaharlal Nehru was invited by Lord Wavell to form interim government in India in 1946.
The Parliament of UK passed the Indian Independence Act of 1947. Lord Mountbatten, the last Viceroy of India, planned for the partition of India into India and Pakistan on the eve of India's independence. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India, delivered his speech, Trust with Destiny, in the Constituent Assembly in the Parliament.
Long years ago,
We made a tryst with destiny, and now the time has come when we shall redeem our pledge, not wholly or in full measure, but very substantially. At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India shall awake to life and freedom. A moment comes, which comes, but very rarely in history, when we step out from the old to the new, when an age ends, when the soul of a nation long suppressed finds utterance. It is a fateful moment for all of us in India, for all Asia and for the world. A new star rises, the star of freedom in the east. A new hope comes into being, a vision long cherished materializes. May the star never set and that hope never be betrayed. Jai Hind.
Finally, after the struggle of almost two centuries, we got our independence on 15th August, the most memorable day in Indian history.
छेड़ो झंझनाओ बार बार
Thank you. afternoon, in white feeling clouds that run. In the evening, the green of waving palms in the breeze. Our hearts fill with pride at these three colors green. Our hearts fill with pride at these three colors green. The saffron gives us courage and inspires sacrifice. The white forest is peace and honesty. The green is festive life and it means prosperity. The central wheel is dharma for eternity. Three colors when we look up to the sky. Three colors make a whole out of the heart. The saffron of the river rising from the morning sun. In the afternoon the white sailing clouds that run. In the evening the green of palms in the breeze. Our hearts fill with pride at these three colors green. Our hearts fill with pride at these three colors green. Our hearts fill with pride at these three colors green.
It is easy to play a musical instrument. All you have to do is to touch the right key at the right time and the instrument will play itself. So now it's time for musical performance.
Nahi kahe tere jaisa koi.